You know, John, the former President Donald Trump, as we've been reporting, he met with the Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy today down at Palm Beach, put out a statement afterwards. The Trump campaign put out a statement saying his endorsement means more than perhaps any endorsement at any time. That's the former President of the United States talking about his own endorsement. What do you make of that?
Well, that picture speaks more than a thousand words. It speaks a million words. Look, the former president likes himself. There's no surprise there. That's not breaking news. He thinks he's the most powerful president ever. Look, his political standing has been diminished significantly nationally. However, that picture tells you everything you need to know. Kevin McCarthy wants to be speaker. The Democrats have a very narrow majority in the House. Kevin McCarthy thinks kissing the ring and making this, without a doubt, the party of Trump going forward for the next 2 years is his path to the speakership. What is the effect of that? Wolf, you see it. You see it in the conversation we're just having about Marjorie Taylor Greene. You see it today in Matt Gaetz, a rank-and-file Trumpy Republican member of the House from Florida, going to Wyoming in Liz Cheney's district, calling her corrupt, saying she's part of an insider club in Washington, saying Mitch McConnell is in that club, too, a club he says is screwing the American people every day. So Kevin McCarthy does not have control over his own caucus now because they know, and through his actions today, he supports this. They have one leader, Donald Trump, period. Look at what happened today with Kevin McCarthy. Watch what these House Trump-like, Trump-loving Republicans are saying in the House. Look at the test vote in the Senate yesterday. So if you hear a Republican saying we're trying to break from President Trump, just turn down the volume because it's not a serious movement. It's his party, period.
And can I just add that, you know, Kevin McCarthy had a phone call with his members yesterday where he said, cut out the crap of fighting with each other. And then what did he do? He took sides today. He went to go see Donald Trump to tell him how much he loved him, to make sure that Donald Trump would welcome him back into the fold, because remember, he went on the floor at one point and said that Donald Trump bears responsibility for January 6th. Then he kind of took it back. But he took sides today. Matt Gaetz is free to do whatever he wants. And the president, the ex-president, wants to see Liz Cheney kicked out of leadership. McCarthy has said she ought to remain, but he has concerns about her. Let's see what he says when he comes back. He took sides today because he needs the money, because he wants to be speaker.
There are Republicans, though, John, who agree with Liz Cheney, who agree with Adam Kinzinger, other Republicans who are saying the former president has been a disaster for the Republican Party, and they got to move on. They got to get new leadership, right?
Yes, there are, but they are a distinct minority. It's a handful, maybe a dozen members of the House. 10 House Republicans voted to impeach the president. There might be twice that many who will publicly say the party needs to at least distance itself from him. But you just saw that vote, Wolf, you know, 45 of the 50 Republican senators saying they don't want to have an impeachment trial. You do have Republican governors like Larry Hogan of Maryland, Charlie Baker of Massachusetts, but they're more centrist to almost liberal Republicans, moderate Republicans. This is Trump's party, plain and simple. And the calculation here is about 2022. You have a 50-50 Senate. You have the smallest House majority for the Democrats that we've had in some time. The Republicans think they can get power back, but they know they will not if they have the Civil War. So those voices saying Republicans need to make a 10 or a 20-year play here. Look at demographics. Look at college-educated people. Look at younger people. Look at voters of color. They're being drowned out by the people who are looking at 2022, saying Republicans can take back power. At least they believe they can. But they know to do that, they need Trump, period.
You know, Gloria, Kevin McCarthy was warned not to go down to Florida, with one source telling us it makes it look like he's, quote, crawling back to Trump. Does the GOP see a path forward without Trump?
Well, as you can see today from that picture, and I agree with John, it tells you everything you need to know. No, they don't. Those are forced smiles there. And what Kevin McCarthy is doing is enabling Donald Trump and saying, you can still be our kingmaker. We want you to be our kingmaker. What we all know about Donald Trump is that he cares about himself. He wants to be back in the spotlight. He probably misses it. This is about him. He doesn't care about saving the Republican Party. He would like to be able to say that he is important. And what Kevin McCarthy did was give him all the oxygen he needs to start doing that again. So McCarthy gave the signal, we're going to get the majority. It's going to be Donald Trump's majority if that's the way, the only way I can get it. And I think that's what he cares about. He wants to be the speaker.